This is the procedure for calibrating or adjusting the calibration of a central tool micrometer. This particular brand does it really cheesy, in my opinion. So you'll need a gauge block or a reference surface or something in order to do this. So right now it's got a friction knob here. Right now it's perfect at 1, but I'm going to show you, if it wasn't perfect, what to do. You can take this and unscrew it. I'm going to lock this. Unscrew the end. Now adjust it. You put your Allen wrench in here and rotate it and loosen it. And all it does is it clamps down on the shaft. So this can go in and out, which is really weird. So anyway, you loosen this and then you turn it until you're lined up this way and lined up on the line. And once you've got both of those done, I think I need it. Yeah. Then you can tighten it again. Okay. Now we'll check it again. Oh, got to put the end back on. Put the end on and then we can check it for 0. Which it is. We got a good reading there. And then I'm going to go ahead and check it for 2 inches, the full motion, to see how accurate this thing is. This is only goes to the thousandths. This doesn't go to the tenth. There's no vernier scale to match that to. Okay, this should fit in there. I'll make sure I'm clean. There we go. Yep, right at 0 again. So this thing is adjusted. That's how you adjust a central tool micrometer. Different manufacturers have different ways of doing it. Sterrett and stuff have a, you need a little spanner wrench to tighten it. But this is the first one I've seen that you can actually slide the barrel back and forth, which is pretty hokey. But once you get it adjusted, you know you're good. Now I would check this on, you know, every 6 or 7 times you pulled this out to use it, because if you were to twist this too hard or bite down on this, you could turn this and have it spin on that shaft.